students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding a first step to wholesome reform written by R.K. Raghavan and D. Shivanandan. Now from examination point of view, this will help you in general studies mains examination paper 2, plus this is important for public administration optional students. Now this editorial is about the reforms in the police administration. Now, in order to understand the police administration, first of all, we need to understand the importance of good governance. Now, what is this concept of good governance and how this is related to the reform in the police administration? Now, this concept of good governance, it is a 2-decade-old concept. Now, good governance means a kind of administrative system that suo moto means by itself promotes transparency, by itself promotes accountability, by itself promotes responsibility, and it is an efficient system, a system of administration that is based on rule of law. Now what is meant by rule of law? It means administration that is being carried out as per the rules and the regulations. Administration that is transparent, administration that is visibly not corrupt and is also not corrupt in its conduct. Now this is what is meant by good governance. Now when it comes to police administration is again a subset of the complete administration. So police administration must also envelop itself with this entire concept of good governance. Now this entire concept of good governance should be introduced in police administration, and this editorial is about a one step that has been taken by the courts in order to introduce good governance in police administration. And what is that first step? This first step is the introduction of uploading the first information report on the website of police. Now why this has been called as one of the potent steps, why this has been called as the most important thing in the introduction of good governance in police administration? Now when it comes to tackling the crime, when it comes to taming the fissiparous agents in the society, when it comes to maintaining law and order, police has got one very important tool in its hand, and that tool is the lodging of first information report. But when it comes to taming of the reform, taming of the crime in the society, what police actually does? The police uses this tool of first information report as one to earn money, as one to inflict police administration with corruption, as one to introduce and institutionalize corruption in police administration. Now how this tool is used as an instrument to unleash corruption in police administration? Generally what police does is, this FIR is not provided to the party who has been named in the FIR. This FIR is generally provided only once some amount, some rupee, some graft has been paid to the station house officer, that is SHO. Without paying the graft, without greasing the palms, generally this FIR is not given. Now what is the importance of the FIR? Now why this FIR is important? Why somebody who has committed a crime should have access to this FIR? And why somebody against whom a crime has been committed should also know about what kind of charges has been leveled against the person who has committed the crime? This FIR becomes basis for protecting the person by a lawyer who has committed the crime. Now, without knowing about what is mentioned in the FIR, it is actually not possible for a lawyer to protect the person who has committed a crime. And it is also not possible for the victim to know exactly about what has been leveled against the instigator of the crime. So for the justice to be completely done, for the justice to be completely engendered, for the justice to be completely institutionalized, it is important that such a piece of information should be made public at the earliest. And this piece of information is very, very important in the criminal justice system. This piece of information is generally used by the police to instigate corruption, to institutionalize corruption. So this piece of information should be made public as soon as possible. Though this verdict is related to the older verdicts of police reforming the police administration, like the court has come out with a verdict in Prakash Singh case versus Union of India. That case relates to police introducing reforms in the police, but that verdict was never implemented. It has been implemented half-heartedly. Now that verdict wanted to completely reform the entire police administration. And how could that have happened? That could have happened by changing the Indian Penal Code 1861. The entire IPC was supposed to be changed. Now when it comes to police in India, police, it is actually a baggage of the British era. The police that we are having, it is something that we have bequeathed from the past. It is actually the legacy of the Britishers. The crime, the type of the crimes that are committed in the society, they are again a baggage of the Britishers. The way the crime is dealt, again it is a baggage of the Britishers. The ethos, the value system is again the legacy of the Britishers. So what kind of police administrative system we want? What kind of a police administration today's society expect? They expect good governance in police administration. And what is good governance in police administration? That is transparency, that is accountability, that is responsibility, that is engendering the answerability, that is engendering rule of law, that is engendering welfareism, that is engendering law and order, that is engendering peace in the society. And this is not possible if the entire past baggage will be lurking over the police system, over the police institution in India. So what we require is a change, what we require is a transformation. And this step of the court is the first step that will help to make this change really firm. So this was all for the editorial decode. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of channel is Brainy IAS. You can contact me at 8459400000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes and entire civil services preparation. And in order to build the information of the classes, please visit our website brainyias.com. You can also contact me at 8459400000 in case you have any sort of query about civil services preparation. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.